I saw the best minds of my generation destroyed by madness, starving, hysterical, naked, dragging themselves through the Negro streets at dawn looking for an angry fix. Angel-headed hipsters burning for the ancient heavenly connection to the starry dynamo and the machinery of night. Poverty and tatters and hollow-eyed and high, sat up smoking in the supernatural darkness of cold water flats, floating across the tops of cities, contemplating who bared their brains to heaven under the L and saw Mohammedan angels staggering on tenement roofs illuminated, who passed through universities with radiant, cool eyes hallucinating Arkansas and Blake Light tragedy among the scholars of war, who were expelled from the academies for crazy and publishing obscene odes on the windows of the skull, who cowered in rooms in underwear, burning their money in waste baskets and listening to the terror through the wall, who got busted in their pubic beards, returning through Laredo with a belt of marijuana for New York, who ate fire in paint hotels or drank turpentine in paradise, death or purgatory, their torsos night after night with dreams, with drugs, with waking nightmares, alcohol and cock and endless balls, incomparable blind street and shuddering cloud and lightning in the mind, leaping toward poles of Canada and Patterson, illuminating all motionless world of time between peyote solidities of halls, backyard green trees, cemetery dawns, wine drunken to rooftops, storefront of T-head ride, neon blinking traffic light, sun and moon and tree vibrations in the roaring winter dusts of Brooklyn, ash can rantings and kind king minds who chained themselves to subways for the endless ride from Battery to Holy, Bronx on Benzedrine, until the noise of wheels and children brought them down shuddering, mouth racked and battered, bleak rain, all drained of brilliance in the drear light of zoo, who sank all night in submarine light, his cafeteria floated out and sat to the stale beer afternoon in desolate Fugazi's bar in the village, listening to the crack of doom on the hydrogen jukebox, who talked continuously, 70 from park to pad to bar to Bellevue to museum to the Brooklyn Bridge, lost battalion of platonic converses jumping down the stoops, off fire escapes, off windowsills, off Empire State, out of the moon, yakety yakking, screaming, vomiting, whispering, facts and memories and anecdotes and eyeball kicks and shocks of hospitals and jails and wars, whole intellects discharged in total recall for 7 days and nights with brilliant eyes, meat for the synagogue cast on the pavement, who vanished into nowhere, Jersey leaving a trail of ambiguous picture postcards of Atlantic City Hall, suffering eastern sweats and Tangerine bone grindings and migraines of China under junk withdrawal in Newark's bleak furnished room, who wandered around and around at midnight in the railroad yard wondering where to go and went, leaving no broken hearts, who lit cigarettes in boxcars, 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 racketing through snow toward lonesome farms in Grandfather Night, who studied Plotinus, Poe, St. John of the Cross, telepathy, and Bob Kabbalah, because the cosmos instinctively voted at their feet in Kansas, who loaned it to the streets of Idaho, seeking visionary Indian angels, were visionary Indian angels, who thought they were only mad when Baltimore gleamed in supernatural ecstasy, who jumped in limousines with the Chinamen of Oklahoma on the impulse of winter, midnight, streetlight, small town, rain, who lounged hungry and lonesome through Houston seeking jazz or sex or soup, and followed the brilliant Spaniard to converse about American eternity, a hopeless task, and took ship to Africa, who disappeared into the volcanoes of Mexico, leaving behind nothing but the shadow of dungarees and the lava and ash of poetry scattered in fireplace Chicago, who reappeared on the West Coast investigating the FBI for Martin Luther King in beards and shorts, with big pacifist eyes, sexy in their dark skin, out incomprehensible leafs, who burned cigarette holes in their arms protesting the narcotic tobacco haze of capitalism, who distributed super communist pamphlets on Union Square, weeping and undressing while the sirens of Los Alamos wailed them down, and wailed down Wall Street, and the Staten Island Ferry also wailed, who broke down crying in white gymnasiums, naked and trembling before the machinery of other skeletons, who bit detectives in the neck and shrieked with delight in police cars for their own, no crime but their own wild cooking, ferocity and intoxication, who howled on their knees in the subway and were dragged off the roof waving genitals and manuscripts, who let themselves be fucked in the ass by saintly motorcyclists and screamed with joy, who blew and were blown by those human seraphim, the sailors, caresses of Atlantic and Caribbean love, who in the morning and the evenings in rose gardens and the grass of public parks and cemeteries, scattering them in freely to whomever, come who may, who ended trying to giggle but wound up with a sob behind a partition in a Turkish bath when the blonde and naked angel came to pierce them with a sword, who copulated ecstatic and insatiate with a bottle of beer, a girlfriend, a sweetheart, a package of cigarettes, a candle, and fell off the bed and continued along the floor and down the hall and ended fainting on the wall with a vision of ultimate cunt and cum eluding the last jism of consciousness, who sweetened the snatches of a million girls trembling in the sunset and were red-eyed in the morning prepared to sweeten the snatch of the sunrise, flashing buttocks under barns and naked in the lake, who went out whoring through Colorado in myriad stolen night cars, Neil Cassidy, secret hero of these poems, Coxman and Adonis of Denver, joy to the memory of his innumerable lays of girls in lots and diner backyard, moves as rickety rows on mountaintops in caves or with gaunt waitresses in familiar roadside lonely petticoat upliftings, and especially gas station solipsisms of and hometown alleys too, who faded out in vast sordid movies, were shifted in dreams, woke on a sudden Manhattan, picked themselves up out of basements hung over with heartless tokay and horrors of Third Avenue elevated train iron dreams, and stumbled to unemployed offices, who walked all night with their shoes full of blood on the snowbank docks, waiting for a door in the East River to open to a room full of steam, heat, and opium, who created suicidal dramas on the apartment cliff banks and under the wartime blue floodlight of the moon, and their heads shall be crowned with laurel and oblivion, who ate the lamb stew of the imagination or digested the crab at the muddy bottom of the rivers of Bowery, who wept at the romance of their streets with their push carts full of onions and bad music, who sat in boxes breathing in the darkness under the bridge and rose up to build harpsichords in their lofts, who on the sixth floor of Harlem crowned with flame under the tubercular skies by orange crates of theology, who scribbled all night rocking in midnight Dulman realms over stanzas of lofty incantatory gibberish, who cooked rotten animals, lung, heart, feet, tail, borscht, and tortillas, dreaming of the pure vegetable kingdom, who plunged themselves under meat trucks looking for an egg, who threw their watches off the roof to cast their ballot for eternity outside time, and alarm clocks fell on their heads every day for the aid, who cut their wrists three times successively, unsuccessfully, gave up, and were forced to open antique stores down south where they thought they were growing old and cried, who were burned alive in their innocent flannel suits on Madison Avenue amid blasts of leaden verse and the tanked up clatter of the iron regiments of fashion and the nitroglycerin shrieks of the fairies of advertising and the mustard gas of sinister agent editors, or were run down by the drunken taxicabs of absolute reality, who jumped off the Brooklyn Bridge, this actually happened, and walked away unknown and forgotten into the ghost days of Chinatown alleyways and trucks, one free beer, who sang out of their windows in despair, fell out of the subway, jumped in the filthy Passaic outside of Paterson, New Jersey, leaped on Negroes, cried all over the street, danced on broken wine glasses barefoot, smashed phonograph records of nostalgic European 1930s German jazz, finished the whiskey and threw up groaning into the bloody toilet, moans in their ears and the blast of colossal steam whistles, who barreled down the highways of the past, journeying to each other's hot rod, glow, solitude watch, or Birmingham jazz incarnation, who drove cross-country 72 hours to find out if I had a vision, or you had a vision, or he had a vision, to find out eternity, who journeyed to Denver, who died in Denver, who came back to Denver and waited in vain, watched over Denver and brooded and loaned in Denver, and finally went away to find out the time, and now, Denver is lonesome for her heroes, who fell on their knees in hopeless cathedrals for each other's salvation and light and breasts until the soul illuminated its hair for a second, who crashed to their minds in jail, waiting impossible criminals with goldens and the charm of reality in their hearts, who sang sweet blues to Alcatraz, who retired to Mexico to Veda habit, or Rocky Mount to tender Buddha, or Tanger to boys, or Southern Pacific to the black locomotive, or Harvard to Narcissus, to Woodlawn, to the Daisy Chain, or Grave, demanded sanity trials, accusing the radio of hypnotism, and were left with their insanity and their hands and a hung jury, who threw potato salad at College of the City of New York lecturers on European modernist Dadaism, and subsequently presented themselves on the granite steps of the madhouse with shaven heads and Harlequin speech of suicide, demanding instantaneous lobotomy, and who instead the concrete of insulin, metrosol, electricity, hydrotherapy, psychotherapy, occupational therapy, ping pong, and amnesia, who in humorless protest overturned only one symbolic ping pong table, resting briefly in catatonia, returning years later truly bald except for a wig of blood and tears and fingers to the visible madman doom of the wards of the mad towns of the East, pilgrim states, Rocklands and Greystone hospitals, fetid halls, bickering with echoes of the soul, rocking and rolling night solitude, Ben Goldman realms of love, dream of life a nightmare, bodies turned to stone as heavy moon, with mother finally asterisked, and the last fantastic flung out of the tenement window, and the last door closed at 4 a.m., and the last telephone slammed at the wall in reply, and the last furnished room emptied down to the last piece of mental furniture, a yellow paper rope twisted on a wire hanger in the closet, and even that imaginary, nothing but a hopeful little bit of hallucination. Ah, Carl, while you are not safe, I am not safe. And now you're really in the total animal soup of time. And who therefore ran through the icy streets, obsessed with a sudden flash of the alchemy of the use of ellipsis, catalog, meter, and being plain, who dreamt and made incarnate gaps in time and space through images juxtaposed, and trapped the archangel of the soul between two visual images, and joined the elemental verbs and set the noun and dash of consciousness together with sensation of pater omnipotens aeterna deus to recreate the syntax and measure of poor human prose and stand before you speechless, intelligent, and shaking with shame, rejected yet confessed the soul to conform to the rhythm of thought in his naked and endless head, the madman, bomb, and angel beat in time unknown, yet putting down what might be left to say in time come after death, and rose reared in the ghostly clothes of jazz in the gold horn shadow of the band, and blew the suffering of America's naked mind for love into an sunny saxophone cry that shivered the cities down to the last radio with the absolute heart of the poem of life butchered out of their own body. Good eat 1,000 years. What sphinx of cement and aluminum bashed open their skulls and ate up theirs in imagination? Moloch, solitude, filth, ugliness, ash cans and unobtainable dollars, children screaming under the stairways, boys sobbing in armies, old men weeping homeless in the park. Moloch, nightmare of Moloch, Moloch the loves, mental Moloch. Moloch, the heavy judger of men. Moloch, the incomprehensible prison. Moloch, the crossbone, soulless jailhouse and congress of sorrows. Moloch, whose buildings are judgment. Moloch, the vast stone of war. Moloch, the stunned governments. Moloch, whose mind is pure machinery. Moloch, whose blood is running money. Moloch, whose fingers are tin army. Moloch, whose breast is a cannibal dynamo. Moloch, whose ear is a smoking tomb. Moloch, whose eyes are 1,000 blind windows. Moloch, whose skyscrapers stand in the long streets like endless Jehovah's. Moloch, whose factories dream and croak in the fog. Moloch, whose smokestacks and antennae crown the cities. Moloch, whose love is endless oil and stone. Moloch, whose soul is electricity and banks. Moloch, whose poverty is the specter of genius. Moloch, whose fate is a cloud of sexless hydrogen. Moloch, whose name is the mind. Moloch, in whom I sit lonely. Moloch, in whom I dream angels. Crazy in Moloch, sucker in Moloch, lack love and manless in Moloch. Moloch, who entered my soul early. Moloch, in whom I am a consciousness without a body. Moloch, who frightened me out of my natural energy. Moloch, whom I abandon. Wake up in Moloch, light streaming out of the sky. Moloch, Moloch, robot apartments, invisible suburbs, skeleton treasuries, blind capitals, demonic industries, spectral nations, invincible madhouses, granite cocks, monstrous bombs. They broke their backs lifting Moloch to heaven. Pavements, trees, radios, tons, lifting the city to heaven which exists and is everywhere about us. Visions, omens, hallucinations, miracles, ecstasies, gone down American River. Dreams, adorations, illuminations, religions, the whole boatload of sieve bullshit. Breakthroughs over the river, crucifixions gone down the flood, highs, epiphanies, despairs, 10 years, animal screams and suicides, minds, new loves, a generation down on the rocks of time, real holy laughter in the river. They saw the wild eyes, the holy yells. They bade farewell. They jumped off the roof to solitude, waving, carrying flowers down the river, into the street. Carl Solomon, I'm with you in Rockland where you're madder than I am. I'm with you in Rockland where you must feel very strange. I'm with you in Rockland where you imitate the shade of my mother. I'm with you in Rockland where you've murdered your 12 secretaries. I'm with you in Rockland where you laugh at this invisible humor. I'm with you in Rockland where we are great writers on the same dreadful typewriter. I'm with you in Rockland where your condition has become serious and is reported on the radio. I'm with you in Rockland where the faculties of the skull no longer admit the worms of the senses. I'm with you in Rockland where you drink the tea of the breasts of the spinsters of Utica. I'm with you in Rockland where you pun on the bodies of your nurses, the harpies of the Bronx. I'm with you in Rockland where you scream in a straitjacket that you're losing the game of the actual ping pong of the abyss. I'm with you in Rockland where you bang on the catatonic piano. The soul is an immortal that should never die ungodly in an armed madhouse. I'm with you in Rockland where 50 more shocks will never return your soul to its body again from its pilgrimage to a cross in the void. I'm with you in Rockland where you accuse doctors of insanity and plot the Hebrew socialist revolution against the fascist national Golgotha. I'm with you in Rockland where you split the heavens of Long Island and resurrect your living human Jesus from the superhuman tomb. I'm with you in Rockland where there are 12,000 mad comrades all together singing the final stanzas of the Internationale. I'm with you in Rockland where we hug and kiss the inmates under our bed sheets. The United States that coughs all night and won't let us sleep. I'm with you in Rockland where we wake up electrified out of the coma by our own souls' airplanes roaring over the roof. They've come to drop angelic bombs. The hospital illuminates itself. Imaginary walls collapse. Oh, skinny legions, run outside. Oh, starry spangled chuck of mercy. The eternal war is here. Oh, victory, forget your underwear. Pray. I'm with you in Rockland. In my dreams, you walk dripping from a journey on the highway across America into the door of my cottage in the western night.